In his 22nd start at Las Vegas Motor Speedway, Kurt Busch, a veteran of the Cup Series, finally broke through and earned that elusive hometown win in Sin City.
It's all or nothing for a lot of these playoff drivers.
Let's do it today. Let's get the job done and advance.
Pit road is now open, and it's going to get very busy.
Caution, debris.
This is certainly going to be a benefit for guys like Kurt Busch.
Okay, man, cinch those belts up. Here we go.
Kurt Busch gets a great jump.
Bring him back to the checkers here, man.
To relive that win and share how the 2021 season has kicked off for him, Kurt Busch joins Jamie Little for a new edition of Off Track.
Welcome into Off Track, and I'm so excited to have you because you have definitely made a splash in the beginning of the season. You're just so aggressive and you're just driving with tremendous heart. What's behind this recently?
I'm just giving back to the team that's given me so much. You know, all the Ganassi guys went to work this offseason with trying to uncover all the little things, because with the rules package staying the same and everything that we're challenged with no practice and qualifying at a lot of our races, we've got to just find those little last details.
Well, I'll tell you what, you guys all together as a team got it done the last time you went to Las Vegas. Finally, Kurt, you got that win at your home track. Going back now, knowing you got that win, how fun is that?
I had beat myself at Vegas so many times, and it's awesome to finally win there and to have that moment. It was even extra without the fans, because I felt everybody's spirit from all my old crew members, family, friends. Everybody finally said, see, we knew you could do it, and finally got it done with nobody there, but it's great to go back and try to defend this win.
So the important question is, are you getting the best watermelons out there from Ross? That's just his thing, right?
It's great having his perspective of being a new guy, because he's technically not a rookie. It's just that he's a rookie with a top-level team with top-level expectations. And I think he'll get settled in here after, like, these next two races is what I told him.
Well, one thing that it seems like you're having some fun with is also the TV side of things. You did Xfinity last week, and you'll be back in the booth at your hometown of Las Vegas. How do you feel like it's going?
It's a blast learning something new, challenging myself to do something different. And also with COVID and the pandemic and the way it's changed our schedule, it gives me more time. But it also gets me in race rhythm for race weekend.
So, Kurt, you had put out a video, or Monster did, and you kind of alluded to, this could be my last year, you know, kind of. And it got a lot of people talking, like, does Kurt have plans of retiring? Do you at this point?
It's a cool teaser of what does the future hold for me, but also the story it tells is the satisfaction and the cool highlights of my career. It is just neat to tie it all together with some fun subliminal messaging about what my future holds.
Well, thanks for joining us today, Kurt. Looking forward to seeing what you could do this weekend and working with you again on the television side.
That's perfect. We'll see you there, Jamie.
For more great NASCAR on Fox content, subscribe to our channel. It's somewhere right around here.